between Anarchy and Longzhu Incredible Miracle. And the Azir ban right off the bat against Frozen, I think obviously IM is going to have Frozen focused pretty heavily.
Yeah, and IM, you have to imagine the Gragas and the Zed bans will be falling into place. Zed nerfed in 5.9, though. They may not be as concerned about that as they used to be, considering it is harder for Zed to just pop in and immediately pop out if he makes a mistake on his death mark. You do have to wait for that 1 second to pass now.
That is a long second for Zed players, too.
Yeah, it gives you some time to CC him and punish him and provides a little bit more counterplay. So, Anarchy, thinking about their next ban here, unless they want to first pick Cassiopeia.
Maybe that wouldn't be a good good pickup for Mickey.
And Gnar, as suspected, banned out. That Apple was carrying very hard on that champion during the qualifiers, so just take it away, as we saw Jhin'er do as well, and there is the Zed.
Yeah, so even with the nerfs, still worried about Mickey's Zed. He has been a very good Zed player.
Well, his LeBlanc and Vladimir have been able to be contained. His Zed, not so much, so I think you're just the most worried about that champion, considering he is such a specialist.
I still feel like his Vlad is a bit better. I will see him. He's usually kind of, it seems like he's sort of fallen back on the Vlad pick when he feels a bit.
Yeah,
there's a LeBlanc ban.
Anarchy not going to first pick it, so Gragas, I would imagine, would be the last ban here. Lyra's Gragas mechanics have been very solid.
Yeah.
And I wouldn't give him a chance to get that playmaking champion early in the game.
Yeah, I am thinking long and hard about it. See, that's I am thinking. Oh, now they're talking a little bit. But what will the result of the thinking and the talking be? It will be a ban of Ahri.
Oh, okay.
Interesting. So will the Cassiopeia be first picked? Will they grab the Gragas? A couple good options for Anarchy going into this.
Yeah, they're forcing them to pick between the Cassie and the Gragas right here, like you're saying, Doa. And that's a hard decision to make because you really don't want to give that Cassiopeia over to Frozen. But
yeah.
Lyra loves to play that Gragas, and that is a champion that Anarchy has seen the most success on themselves.
I think you take the Gragas.
I think you take the Gragas too.
Yeah. All right. Looks like they agree. We could coach Anarchy. And two picks for IM now. Let's see what they decide to go with. Yo, do they actually want to play this Cassiopeia? Looks like they're going to take the Hecarim away from CV Max.
And we don't really know if Mickey can play the Cassiopeia particularly well.
It's true, too. Yeah.
IM may not prioritize it for that reason, but Hecarim without the Gnar in the game, Apple should be able to play that champion and carry on it. And you want to take it away from CV Max as well, because what are his fallbacks? Fizz or Rengar? You're not really concerned about those. So grab the Hecarim early. Alistar also very solid.
Yeah, Alistar quickly becoming like the top support right now in the Korean meta. Alistar Thresh are the priority picks, and they will go ahead and take Hecarim and Alistar. So two more picks over to Anarchy. And will we maybe see this top Rek'Sai for CV Max? They hovered over it for a moment.
Yeah, I think you can definitely take the Rek'Sai here for Lyra, or for CV Max, as you're saying, and just have Lyra play that comfort pick of the Gragas, considering no jungler has been selected so far for Incredible Miracle.
Yeah.
I suppose they could try and jungle Hecarim with the changes made to Rampage on 5.9. That is more viable than it used to be.
That's true. The clear is a little bit better on his Q now.
Yeah, it's a lot better.
Yeah. Huh. What are we going to see? I'd love to see Mickey play Orianna, actually. That'd be a fun champion to watch. But they might just default back to that Vladimir again, it looks like. Unless they go with the Lulu. And they will. Okay. So the Lulu, a bit of a flex pick, obviously. Don't know where that one's going to go just yet.
Yeah, I imagine they're going to take the Thresh with the Jinx, though, when they lock it in and just play a comp that revolves around Jinx, protecting that Jinx.
Makes sense.
With as big of shield and whimsy as possible, especially since there's that Gragas to get the single targets set up to have Jinx reset. Now, we could see our first Ashe in Korea. We did see Fnatic play Ashe earlier today in their match.
Last night for Europe.
Yes, last night for Europe, early in the morning.
I'd love to see Ashe. I think new Ashe is quite good. And a lot of teams here in Korea have been talking about it, but we may just see a very tanky team come out of IM. or Twisted Fate.
Yeah, okay. Twisted Fate to set up some plays on the lane. Quirky Rek'Sai. Yeah, you don't have to pick the mid laner here, so just flashing over that Twisted Fate for a moment before the Rek'Sai is locked in, so we won't have a chance to see Anarchy try out that top lane Rek'Sai, which is very strong right now.
Right.
And then he's going for some early siege. So a lot of options right now.
So maybe a top Lulu then, perhaps. Or it could still be a support Lulu top Nautilus. We don't know.
Yep, that you never know. Absolutely possible.
It's a lot of flex picks right now in League, which is pretty cool.
I agree. That's how it should be.
Yeah.
Makes the draft phase much more interesting.
Definitely. Some better than others. And again, that Morgana could be going support mid or top.
You'd really think that the Thresh would come in here.
And he would just send the Nautilus top lane?
Don't play Nautilus.
Oh, yeah. Suppose they can switch it over. 3-2-1, and locked in. So Morgana, Nautilus.
So we have no idea where any of these champions are going.
Yeah,
this is a very confusing draft from Anarchy because any of those champions could be played support, mid, or top. So this is a huge round of flex picks from Anarchy to trick their opponents. Well, you wouldn't play Nautilus mid, you could play him support or top, and then Lulu and Morgana could be played theoretically in any of those positions. And I don't know if CB Max's strategy is. Probably, if I had to guess, top Morgana, mid Lulu, support Nautilus, and just peel for Jinx.
That would probably be the setup that would kind of work most of the player's strengths, I think.
Yeah,
I don't think you want to put Mickey on Morgana.
Yeah, I think you just take the Cassiopeia, and that's what he's going to do. So just Cassiopeia once again for Frozen. We'll see if he can take a win on it in this game. And that is a strong composition. Picking the Jinx into the Hecarim is a bit bold, I have to say. Of course, you get that flank down, and the Jinx will just be annihilated by the Hecarim, and it looks like top Nautilus it will be, actually.
Well, they've got about 12 more seconds to change it, and I keep waiting. But yeah, right now, looks like top Nautilus for CV Max.
Not surprising he would play weird stuff like top Nautilus. He's just following in the footsteps of Trace and Duke. And we'll see if he does as well on it. Duke actually did pick up a win on the top Nautilus as part of their Protect the Vein composition.
Yep, and it will indeed be a top Nautilus, this time to protect the Jinx, though.
So, three supports and a Lulu. They've got great skirmishing ability with that Gragas as well. So, IM will have to be quite cautious when it comes to their positioning in this game. And not getting broken apart by the explosive cast, because Sangyun will be able to reset very, very easily and charge down the enemy team with how much speed she has and shields from the Lulu, the Morgana, and of course the Whimsy as well to get her that little bit of an advantage.
You know, Gragas was even a support for a short time, so it's really four supports in my mind. And Jinx, we'll see if it helps Anarchy take a win over IM, or IM will crush them like they did in the qualifiers. Time to get in the game and find out. Faker off to get more MVPs. And welcome to Summoner's Rift Anarchy versus Incredible Miracle. I am fans out in force as usual, and a few Anarchy fans here and there. They're building a bit of a following.
I like the roar cheerful in the crowd. It says, Overlord of this game. All of the enemies ready to be overwhelmed. Dang.
Wow, that is serious, man.
Roar is gonna go ham, I guess, in this one with his Corki.
That's right. Roar's not the type. He's not the type of warlord to just destroy a town. He's the type to let one of them live and send them ahead to the next town to tell them what's coming. You know.
Awesome.
He's evil.
Well, Matador Alistair in this game. Which is more disturbing, Cowboy Alistair or Matador Alistair?
Matador Alistair.
I think that one's more disturbing because he's actually murdering his own kind for the spectacle of it.
That's right. That's why he's doing that happy little sociopath dance there.
Alistair's sociopath dance, is that what that is?
That's right. Look for Christian Bale in American Alistair later this year. It's going to be intense.
No, it's okay. I actually like to skip the American Alistairs most of the time.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I hear you. But then you got to wonder, where's the beef?
No. No, I don't. I don't at all. Well, leash onto the Grop for Tucson. Meanwhile, Lane Freeze in the bottom side coming in while Hecarim will just go ahead and solo out that Raptor camp. Apple actually going for Ignite this game instead of Smite.
That's interesting, yeah.
That's the first time we've seen that on a Hecarim this season.
You'd think the 1v1.
Nah, I think you just get Ignite to kill the Jinx.
I mean, I think it is all about killing the Jinx, yeah.
Although you get the true damage off the Smite as well, so. But the Skirmish Saber was nerfed in this patch, so not quite as powerful as it used to be.
Yeah, a little bit shorter of a time on that one now.
And now Apple going to come into the lane at level 2 and try and deal with this Nautilus.
Yeah, and you can be pretty sure that CV Max, you know, having been a top lane Hecarim player for so long, you know, knows how to play against it as well.
I'm surprised that we're seeing Frozen take Ignite in this game because there's so much crowd control on the side of Anarchy, and this Cassiopeia is just going to be repeatedly locked down by spells like Whimsy and
does seem
the
a bit
Depth Charge
doesn't it?
And Stuns and Roots, yeah. That you may want to go ahead and take Cleanse in this one.
Even Faker takes Cleanse on Cassiopeia.
Yeah, that was in the Ahri matchup, though, so a little different.
True.
Obviously, getting hit by those charms. Different matchup, different summoner spells. But that does surprise me a tad, a hair.
A skosh, a tiny bit. An iota.
That's right.
Well, Nautilus literally just standing there for a moment. Finding ways to make the top lane even more boring. It's difficult, but he's done it. Oh, the crowd laughed right there. That was good. I could pretend that was about what I said.
Wow. So just going to be a lot of farming here in the early game. There's not really much kill pressure to go on. Tucson could maybe find something down on the bottom side, but
yeah,
that's what's been so disappointing about the first two games from Tucson is that he just didn't make moves on the map. He exerted zero pressure on his Rek'Sai and Lee Sin. And you pick those champions because you have the ability to make those plays early on. But just not being there, Lyra looking at Frozen in the mid lane. They want to go for this.
Yep, there's a flash body slam out of Frozen getting low, and that's a very fast first blood for Mickey. Frozen, just barely enough time to flash before he gets taken down.
You have to know that's coming.
Yeah,
I mean,
you should.
Lyra is so focused on the mid lane, and Tucson wanted to get that Scuttle Crab, but Frozen was pushed up right there, and that's the result of it. You have to be careful, but Lyra puts so much emphasis on getting Mickey ahead. Mickey with the first blood gold. Now he's got a chalice to help deal with the Cassiopeia damage early.
Yeah. Well, Ignar and Roar able to do a bit of poking on the bot lane, but so far it's not gaining them a whole lot. Just a little bit of a CS lead. But not really too much to speak of. You know, I think the other issue, too, is that Frozen, you know, he had that Rift Sculler, but there weren't really any other wards around to really keep him safe either.
Yeah, exactly. And the Rift Sculler was just being taken right there, so he had no vision on either of his side brushes. Pretty easy gank.
You know, Anarchy, on the other hand, one of the things I feel they've done pretty well so far in this league is ward, which is...
Yes.
They ward surprisingly well for a team that's kind of new.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. They do place a premium on emphasis. A premium on emphasis. Wow, that was a sentence I just said. A premium on vision is what I said. What I wanted to say, actually.
An emphasis on premium vision.
That's right.
That's right.
Got it out eventually.
I understood perfectly. When you think about it, really, I mean, a ward is like a microtransaction within a game of microtransactions. Because it gives you a short-term buff.
It's all about the purchasing power.
That's right. Yep. It's just ingraining that philosophy into your very play style.
Wow, Frozen being very aggressive, even though he doesn't have level 6 yet. Mickey does. Tucson there to back him up, trying to bait him in, but it's not going to work.
Yep. Meanwhile, Lyra going to walk into this brush. I feel like he was seen, but maybe not. Yeah, Ignar and Roar, I think they know what's up. And then this is still going on.
No pressure onto the top side yet either, despite the fact that CB Max has been pushed up nearly this whole game, and he's playing a champion with very few escapes.
Yeah.
Especially because he can get interrupted out of his hook to a wall.
Look at this already, though, from Lyra, getting some nice deep wards down in bot lane, which is something that Anarchy can take good advantage of later.
Indeed they can. And also pink wards scattered around the mid lane already, just to make sure that Mickey has somewhere to fall back to if the situation demands it. Shooting out the Glitter Lance right there. Frozen finally hitting level 6.
Yeah. I mean, Lulu's already a champion that's pretty good at escaping, too, if she needs to. CS, though, fairly even across the board. A little lead in the top in ADC for IM. But that's not too surprising right now, given the matchups.
Yep. Very slight advantage for Anarchy. It's pretty much just the first Blood Gold at this stage, and everyone else just farming up. It's been a lot of passive early games tonight. Apple going for the Trinity Force first, of course, considering he has no smite for the Cinder Hulk buff. I like the Skirmisher Saber here, choice from Tucson. One more way that they can keep Sangyun locked down, since he's the only real threat.
Yeah.
And Rek'Sai has such good sustain anyway. You have a lot of choices in terms of what you can purchase in this game. But so far, no ganks or no real attempts onto the bottom side. Setting the Jinx behind in this situation could be a very effective strategy for Incredible Miracle, but even though Sangyun has fallen behind in CS and will continue probably to have a little bit of a hard time now that Corki is 6 with that Sheen, killing that Jinx could be absolutely huge right now, and there just hasn't been an attempt.
Yeah. Not yet anyway, but the game is fairly young. I feel like Anarchy wants to try to make a play for this dragon fairly soon. They've certainly got the wards for it. So many pink wards already. 4 of them. Bottom jungle.
They know what the goal is here, is to shut down Mickey and to shut down Sangyun. So play the bottom side of the map. Let CV Max do his thing on the top side, ward for himself, and just make sure that your jungler is constantly on the bottom, so that they can't dive. And
it's working so far. Meanwhile, a bit of an attack up in top lane. CV Max throws the ult onto Tucson, turns around for the stun.
Tucson didn't flash to knock.
Not really. Whoa! Meanwhile, Sangyun gets a kill onto Ignar in bot lane.
Wow.
2v2 for Anarchy working out pretty
well
there.
What happened right there was the Morgana Binding must have landed straight into traps before Ignar could flash. So you have to be able to commit with that flash early, and now Roar has to back off the turret. Lyra looking for a kill, but Tucson didn't flash underneath CV Max in that top lane either, so didn't get the Unburrow knock up, and not really a lot of damage done. And with that, Anarchy is going to take a very easy dragon.
Yeah, only Tucson nearby to harass. We'll see if Frozen comes down or not, but it looks like Anarchy should be able to get this one. Yep, they do.
Yeah, you have a Jinx with a BF sword already, so no problem in taking that first dragon of the game. Apple, in the meantime, trying to duel it out with CV Max in the top, but it is hard to cut through that Nautilus and his tankiness. Oops,
nice.
Tried to knock him out of his dredge line, but
CV Max getting out just in time.
Yeah, didn't quite get the angle there, so
It's
more harassment while he knows it's safe, but that is a comfortable early advantage for Anarchy off of the failed gank in the top side and then the follow-up, which was the 2v2 kill down in bottom.
Yeah. Didn't get a replay of that, but I would imagine it kind of went how you suggested, just kind of chaining the CC pretty well.
It's only really one way that could have happened, especially since Ignar still had his flash up at the end of it. They just burst him down very rapidly. And that was before he hit 6, too, to get out of that situation, just barely before he hit 6.
Not bad. Yeah, Mickey's still definitely holding his own in the mid lane either way, too. And so Anarchy with a tiny bit of an edge. We'll see what they can do to try to capitalize on this. Looks like it might be another attempt onto CV Max up in top lane. Tucson spots him with that Tremor Sense.
He's going to walk down to Ward.
Yeah, that's right. Tucson's going to get behind him. There's a knockup. CV Max in a lot of trouble now. Push back even farther. No flash. Can he possibly get in range to hit the turret? Oh, gets to the wall and makes it out.
Used the Righteous Glory to escape right there.
Yeah.
So actually he got the speed buff because they were in front of him trying to path block him.
Don't you get a buff running towards turrets as well, too?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that is... I'm not sure if it's just enemy turrets, though, actually.
That's what I was wondering, too.
I'm pretty not sure it's just enemy turrets.
That.
But
okay.
Regardless, that was a great use of Righteous Glory, which is why he got that speed buff in order to escape. So unusual to see the Righteous Glory first on a Nautilus. That's not an item. I mean, if we're talking about Trace, he likes to build the Rod of Ages first and then build directly tanky after that, because Nautilus running at you is not a very scary form of engage, even with the Righteous
really.
Glory.
No.
Because he still lacks a bit of that gap closer. Maybe you can set up a dredge line. We'll see how he can use it in this game.
Now, the big benefit, though, for IM is that they've been able to get a nice little CS lead for Apple up in top lane now. So CV Max still in a little bit of trouble, despite getting out. Ooh, we'll see if Mickey can get anything done with this roam. He's going to at least place a ward down. But they don't really know where Apple is, so I guess no roaming ganks or anything from the mid laner.
Yeah, and just those ganks in top side just haven't worked out. They haven't been effective.
Yep. Oh, Lyra.
Yeah, it gets found right there over the wall as the ward is placed down, but that'll be quickly cleared with the pink and that brush.
Yep. Meanwhile, the bot lane getting back to normal. Back to a bit of farming for Songyun and Snowflower and Roar and Ignar.
Yeah, Songyun can go back and probably getting close to picking up some big ticket items now with that kill that he got.
Yeah, might be fairly close to that IE.
Yeah, a couple more minutes. So they're just going to go get the Krugs right now, try and move directly into the Infinity Edge, I think. And yeah, just a recall from Roar right now. Wants to finish off that Phage and actually gets the entire Trinity Force.
Oh, okay.
When he goes back.
Yeah, pretty nice for Roar then. Can start to really poke with those rockets. Been seeing a lot of games though where ADCs aren't moving back until they have like, you know, 3,500, 4,000 gold, things like that.
Well, some of these more slow-paced games too, that's
yeah.
Tends to be the case when they don't feel that pressure in the lane that they're going to be punished for farming at maybe some more risky positions. They'll just wait up for as long as they can. Here's Ignar and Tucson coming in.
Yeah, CV Max flashing right away. Ah, gets knocked out, though, from the dredge line. I don't think he's getting out of this one. It was a nice try, but CV Max in a lot of trouble. Meanwhile, Mickey actually killed Frozen down in mid lane. We'll have to see a replay of that later. Big gank onto CV Max in the meantime, though.
And that was just a solo kill as well, as
Tucson
Void rushes down to save the turret. Not
definitely
sure what's going on with Frozen, because Lyra has his cask and his flash up, so he wasn't there for that one. So a little bit of a duel coming in. Frozen already at half HP, just a flash ignite, and then there's the Glitter Lance at the end after getting the help picks on him.
Wow. And just straight up 1v1ing him. And Frozen seems
and getting the turret as well, so very impressive performance from Mickey so far in this game, just asserting total dominance over his lane.
Wow, and look at this. Lyra and Snowflower just zoning out. I am helping Songyun take that turret. And suddenly, Anarchy moving out to a pretty sizable lead early on here as far as the map presence that they're gaining from taking these turrets.
Yeah, they did lose the tower in top, though, as
That's
a result
true.
Of that pressure. So they find themselves only about 1,000 in advance. And still a lot of trouble with their composition. They have to be able to protect Songyun. If Songyun dies in this game, it is just over for Anarchy. Their entire composition gets cleaned up at that point, but they've got a lot of protection for him, so it will be difficult to do. But IM has a great comp for getting into the back line with the Alistar, the Rek'Sai, of course, the teleport from the Hecarim. So a lot of tools available to take out this Jinx.
And true enough. We'll see if IM can do anything about this dragon that's just come back up again. We've got the Riftsculler. They've got that little speed boost from it. Teleport's available for both top laners as well.
Cutler is already down for Incredible Miracle, but yeah. This is a dangerous situation because Infinity Edge has just been finished for Sungyun.
It's a lot
of
damage.
So
on that
he can be set up very well, especially because Mickey already has a lot of AP to shield and to speed him up.
Uh-oh, Roar may have gotten caught here. Lyra and Sungyun hurting him back towards the turret. Teleports coming in from both top laners. Apple gonna try to run interference while Roar tries to escape. Not gonna be able to get out though, Sungyun. Going to get excited if he gets this kill.
Man.
He does indeed. And now it's going to be really tough to get that dragon. Oh, Ignar in trouble as well. Too caught. Nowhere to run, even with that ult. Flashes over the wall. Snowflare flashes. Activates the ult for Morgana as well, too. Rocket comes in, allowing Lyra, Mickey to catch up. Wild Growth used on Snowflare. Oh, ult over the wall there from Apple. I am trying to turn this one around. Kill comes in for Frozen as well, too. But Jinx getting excited, doing the damage. But now they're on top of him. There's a double kill. For Sungyun, though, nobody's going to be able to take out this Jinx at this point in the fight. Triple kill for Sungyun. They're going to transition that right into an easy second dragon.
So sloppy fight right there from both sides. But in the end, Anarchy gets the angle by wrapping around close to their turret and corralling IM over on their side of the map. So Anarchy able to get those resets. And that's exactly the kind of fight that this Jinx wants right here.
Yep.
Just a couple of people all on their own. Roar, the AD carry, isolated with no mana, goes in and can just run forward with the whimsy, with the get excited, and just pick people off slowly. Everyone else chasing right there. Snowflower committing with the flash ult with his black shield afterwards. Fortunately, that rocket hits while the Unbreakable Will is still up, and Sungyun walks in, he sees his opportunity, let's go on to Ignar, and then Frozen immediately, who's so low with no mana already, able to get the Get Excited, then kite back out. Misses some skill shots right there in terms of the zap, but otherwise pretty nicely positioned by Sungyun.
Yeah, not bad. Put himself in the position to get some kills. He's already up to 5 this game. 5 out of the 7, he just goes back and buys a static shiv.
Well, how does it get much worse? The Lulu and the Jinx are fed. So
yep.
How are you going to kill the Jinx anymore before she kills you? Straight up buying the static ship pre-20 minutes. This
yep.
is an absolute disaster for Incredible Miracle, who just falling apart since they got into Champions. This team looked so clean in the qualifiers, even against Anarchy, like you were saying, Doa.
Yeah, if you go back and watch those games, I am pretty much crushed them.
Yeah, they crushed everybody. The games weren't even close. That's why there was so much interest in them heading into this season. But they've looked confused ever since that time.
Well, you have to wonder if their champion pools just are not big. You know, if what they got in the qualifiers is all they can play. And so when you ban out that Gnar against Apple, ban out some other things, I am kind of falling flat. Looks like they'll be able to claim this mid lane turret, though. So staying even in turrets, at least.
Yeah, just
but yeah.
Back and right off after it.
Yep, I am having issues. I mean, Incredible Miracle's having issues. I don't have any issues. I'm fine. Don't worry about me, guys.
I'm okay. I'm concerned about you, Doa. Don't worry.
I'm a very well-adjusted young man. It's all right.
Not so young anymore. Let's be real.
Hey, well, when you compare me to, like, really old people, I'm pretty young.
I'm comparing you to the esports audience, though.
Yeah, yeah. For that, I'm pretty old, I guess. It's true. Yeah.
It's okay. Well, the Korean casters, except for Cloud Templar, are still older than you.
It's true. It's true. And they say, you know, with age comes wisdom. And I'm trying my best to prove that wrong, but so far, so good.
Well, the Koo Tigers are a pretty young team, and they have wisdom now.
That's true. Yeah, they got wisdom from IM. Oh, Sungyun gets caught, though, with a bunch of CC. Gets out. Wild Growth helping out quite a bit there as well. Random rocket thrown into Tucson. Panic rocket. Don't really know what that was supposed to accomplish. But
wow, not respecting the brush right there at all. So Sungyun walking up before his massively supportive team comp could assist him in that endeavor.
Support team.
Just Sungyun and his entourage, pretty much. President Song Yoon and his Secret Service agents, everybody just dives in front of bullets to protect him.
That's true.
The Secret Service failed him right there, though, pretty badly.
He was nearly taken out. It was like a mild success. Yep.
The least exciting form of success.
It's true. Mild success. Where it's like, yeah, you won, but, you know, should you have really won with Top Nunu and Varus? I don't know. I'm not so sure. Mild success. Yeah. Should you really have done more damage there than their entire team combined?
That wasn't a mild success.
That was a big success.
That was a critical strike.
That was more like, should this have happened?
No.
In a rational world?
No. Well, Song Yoon is going to get a QSS right now to solve his Cassiopeia problems after getting ambushed with... Oh, they're going after him.
Oh, Song Yoon, oh no. Yep, that happened. Where was the Secret Service that time?
Secret Service is really failing here. They're just leaving Song Yoon all by himself in some of these lanes. Song Yoon had no wards on the bottom side of the map.
He had no flash.
To safely make that.
He had no flash either. That was not the greatest. Oh, I am. They find Snowflower and Anarchy a bit leaderless. Goodbye.
And now, actually, IM's going to be able to take some turrets right here as well. This is going to get them a gold lead, surprisingly.
This is kind of how we expected these games to go, though. So we'll see. We'll see what happens from here on out. But a turret taken, yeah. And a little bit of a gold lead for IM at this point.
IM actually making a relatively graceful recovery. Apple moving into that frozen heart. And Lyra looking like he's going to be getting that Randuin, so this is getting increasingly difficult now that some of these kills have come down for Anarchy to deal with, because they didn't group right there and they didn't ward adequately to protect them on their wave clear before they could set up a siege again.
It's like they thought...
And they botched their siege on the tier 2 on the top side by not checking that brush and getting caught out.
It's like they think of Song Yoon as like a little baby bird that they found in their nursing, and they decided that Song Yoon, you know, had been fed enough, he was old enough, that they could just release him out to the world and he could fly free. Be free, Song Yoon. You don't need us anymore.
And then immediately, as soon as the bird escapes your hands, a hawk flies down
and
just grabs it in its talons immediately.
Yep. Or in this case, an apple. Oh, which doesn't make any sense. Tucson tries to make a play, gets pushed back.
Tucson hates using flash for knockups.
Apple coming in over the top, though. Snowflower immediately taken down. Song Yoon forced out of the fight completely by Ignar. Comes back in now. And can Anarchy turn this one around? Looks like they are going to try, but a double kill already for Frozen. There we go. Now a knockup coming in from Tucson.
Oh.
Ignar pushes Song Yoon right back in there. Frozen taken out. Lyra in trouble as well here. Mickey the only one left right now. Oh, there goes Ignar. Gets a kill on the way out at least. A double kill for him.
That was ambitious, considering that this Lulu is actually pretty fed and already has a death cap, and you don't have any more ultimate.
Well, Ignar, he was getting a little bit crazy. He was like, witness me, brother. Went in.
And
he went
did.
For it.
And his team got a dragon for it, so.
Yeah, that's right.
Well done for the collective good, Ignar.
For the good of the cause. Yep.
So let's take a look at this fight again.
Apple
finds a good engage. And look at Ignar. He actually does a good job right here. Exhausts Song Yoon, keeps him out of the fight. And Song Yoon tries to get back in. But by this time, Corky's already gotten the double kill as they've chewed through the front line. And then Ignar does a great job, blows the QSS. I don't know why Song Yoon QSS'd right there.
Right. Panic.
I think it was, actually.
Yep. And then here's Ignar. Oh, wait, we missed it. Oh, meanwhile, this is we're way zoomed in. All right, that was jarring. I don't know what was happening there. Wild red buff action.
IM takes the fight, and they get a smaller gold lead. Now they're going after CV Max.
There's more action. CV Max trying to escape. You know, there's only one word in Mad CV Max's world: survive. he's trying his best. He made it. Good. CV Mad Max. Mad CV Max. Good job.
It's pretty easy to survive when you're a Nautilus with a frozen heart.
In Fury Lane. Can you tell I went and saw Fury Road yesterday?
I know. You were like the last person on Earth to see it.
I guess so.
If you haven't seen it, by the way, and you're watching this.
Oh, it's so good. Oh, man.
As soon as you're done watching this, go watch it.
Yeah, seriously. Doesn't matter if it's 4 a.m. You can find a theater that's open. Well, maybe you can't. But as soon as one is, go and see it. We're not even sponsored by them. It's okay. I'm happy to talk about how great Mad Max was. Well, this game is a bit silly.
It is. As expected.
As expected.
I mean, what did we think this was going to be?
Silly. That's what we thought. And it is. I believe we talked about this earlier in the day. We were having some lunch, and we were like, this is going to be silly. Yep.
Well, at least IM has made the picks onto... Oh, man.
Oh,
not
survive!
On
Run! Well, I don't know if he's getting out of this one. You can make it. Get to the wall. All right. Okay.
Roar.
All right.
Has no flash.
This isn't the Truman Show. Getting the wall isn't going to save you, man. All right. I guess it will this time.
CV Max also confirmed Jim Carrey.
I just referenced the Truman Show. Nobody knows what that is anymore.
That's a great movie.
No one who's watching this has seen that. It is a great movie. But
that's a great movie, and I hate Jim Carrey.
Yeah, that's what a lot of people say about the Truman Show, I think.
I actually really like Jim Carrey in serious roles. I liked him in Eternal Sunshine and The Truman Show. But
he can do a lot of really incredible things with his facial muscles, a lot of interesting expressions, but I don't know. Beyond that, that's about it.
Are you an Ace Ventura apologist, Doa?
No, no, definitely not. Although Fun with Dick and Jane was pretty cool. I like that movie.
I have not seen it, nor will I ever.
It was okay. It was like a half-serious movie. Certainly comedy, but it wasn't as wild and zany as, oh, I don't know, The Mask or something.
Torturous. Oh.
You just think about that movie, and you think about that movie being made. Somebody made that movie.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, teleport coming in right under the flame chompers. Apple's not deterred, though. He's going for, oh, he's deterred.
He was deterred by Morgana, Snowflower. Wow, they really like just ganking around Apple in this top side, but
yeah.
they saw the TP, so pretty easy to stop if you're a Jinx, and you're in range, so the home guard TP utilized. Now CB Max will have TP advantage pretty shortly.
He's doing the 1v3 Snowflower, throws in a little bit of poke.
Okay, you're not going to kill the Nautilus. That's not a thing that will happen. Unless Cassiopeia's there, because he doesn't have a lot of MR yet, but you're not going to kill him otherwise.
There we go. That happened. It's like they're both kind of afraid to fight, you know? It's like you see like two elementary schoolers and they're really mad at each other. They want to fight, but they don't really know how to do it. So they kind of just like dance in and out and slap a little bit.
What an analogy.
Yep. That's how the fights were in my elementary school. It was rural Wisconsin playground fights, man. It's hardcore.
Well, Anarchy has the right idea. They do need to group up and actually siege with this composition. And IM doesn't really have an answer to that as long as they ward their flanks. Sure, there'll be some quirky rockets coming out. But they should be able to wear it down eventually and actually go after some of these towers. Instead, they're just going to split off right now and clear out some delicious minion waves.
Or just do Baron. Let's just do Baron.
Well, we got no wards. Might not give it a shot.
Yeah.
And they have a Cassiopeia. Here we go.
Do it very quickly. And so I am just going to get Baron. But will they lose a fight afterwards? Here we go. Anarchy might try something. Snowflower getting really deep. Whoops, that was a little bit too far. And I am evaporates him as well. Doosan thinking about coming in. Decides against it.
And Dragon up at 20 seconds as well. I am should just walk straight over to this dragon right now with the man advantage.
Yeah.
If they leave and recall, there's actually an opportunity for Anarchy to get it where, well, there is a no. They've got the void rush, so they're just going to come back immediately. Good.
Yeah, I don't think they're going to let this dragon go. They don't want to give Anarchy a third dragon. No mercy. So, IM will be able to get the second dragon here. For their side. A little bit of a 3K gold lead now.
But critically, that Baron buff, so they're going to be able to stop any kind of grouping and sieging by Anarchy, which is exactly what they need. Should be able to create enough zones with the Corki and the Cassiopeia to take down some of these tier two turrets as well.
Yep.
If they actually group up, looks like they want to go for the top side first, getting some wards in.
A lot of wards. Yeah, so I am in pretty firm control of this game.
Roar is going to take the blue buff and then head into the top side. I feel like he could have given that one up. They're wasting a lot of time right now.
They are, really. I mean, they've warded a little bit, but they're not doing a whole lot.
Well, they didn't push up top or mid. If they want to take that blue buff, just go send somebody, anyone, even the support player top, to take out the minion wave so you can actually apply pressure with this Baron. Anarchy is just clearing waves for free.
They're also clearing
a lot of
wards
as well. And then Corki's
going
to recall. What is happening?
I don't know. I think you're getting angry. That's what's happening. I can feel the rage, the Monty rage bar building right now.
Gnar was banned, but it's okay. I've got a rage bar in this game.
That's right. I can tell. We all can. Frozen.
How's the Luden's Echo now?
Yeah, pushing that mid lane. Way to go. You did it.
Rek'Sai also pushing a lane, finally, after they used three-quarters of their Baron buff to do nothing.
Yep.
Some quality map wandering happening from Incredible Miracle.
Some quality milling about.
Quality milling.
That's right. We need a no-loitering sign on Summoner's Rift for IM now.
And so Rek'Sai pushed up top, recalled, and then came into the mid lane without putting any pressure on the turret whatsoever, while Apple furiously clears out minion waves that have been pushed up. How do you apply this little pressure with a Baron buff? I am
disappointed.
Yeah. Well, it's gone now.
The Baron buff is gone.
So much for advantages, right, though?
Well, advantages make the game less exciting.
How are you supposed to have epic team fights and or kill each other if you're gonna take some gold from a turret?
Epic mid laner versus jungler duels while the rest of the team is fighting over turret mid.
Okay. Well, I guess Nautilus is going to TP to the mid lane.
Well, this is still happening. Mickey versus Tucson, the eternal struggle. There we go. Alright. Blocking off the
okay, now Apple has also teleported.
Yeah, he teleported, didn't he? Wow, they both did. And they're, oh, right onto Apple goes CV Max. Oh, Frozen actually gets hit with that dark binding. They're going to turn around. He's going to fight Tucson and Ignar actually coming from behind. Pretty big. Apple with the kill onto Mickey. And I am looking pretty good on this one, pushing Song Yun back into the Incredible Miracle team. Explosive cast helping out there. A double kill for Roar already. Make that a triple kill. And there we go. The fight happened, and I am taking it easily. Tucson, he flashed for that knockup. Did you see that?
I was really impressed.
Yep, and Lyra, there's another flash. Knockup onto him, and the ace. So I am just waiting for the Baron buff to expire to make the fight a little bit more fair, make it a bit more exciting, and then showing their dominance.
Yeah, powering right through to this inhibitor as well.
Yep.
And they'll have plenty of time to get the next dragon, make sure this is an easy win. I mean, the thing is, the team fights from IM haven't been bad when they've actually taken them.
No, they've been good.
They've been good. They've been coordinating well around their objectives, and CV Max goes in right here. Frozen, it looks like they're going to get a binding on him immediately, pile on, but that Seraph's Embrace just saves him. He holds his ground before flashing, so they couldn't kill him, and they use so many cooldowns on that one champion that Apple is able to get into the back line and take out the Jinx. Triple kill from Roar.
Yeah, cleaning up that fight quite nicely. Now Anarchy pushing their way back up the mid lane. Oh, Snowflower gets caught completely again. He's already dead. You missed that one, guys. Wasn't very exciting.
He was just ulted from a brush.
He walked up and died. It's true.
And then died to a couple of Cassiopeia E's without even the Ignite being used.
Yep. Don't really need it.
Whoa. Corki steals it with a rocket, actually.
Yeah, man. Roar looking pretty good. Here comes Tucson.
Yeah, it just makes you wish that IM was more decisive because they definitely have some strong fundamentals when it comes to the team fighting and a certain amount of synergy with each other.
Well, again,
they feel afraid to actually engage some of these fights or make plays on the map.
There were a lot of roster changes, and on an individual level, they all look very good. But you have to wonder what happened to the shot calling on IM, and if they're still trying to kind of figure out how to make decisions as a team with this new roster. It really looks like that.
It's just their shot calling hasn't been there since Wisdom left, but it appeared to be there in the qualifiers when they played more aggressively and actually took more advantages out of the opportunities that were given to them. But Apple has a Frozen Heart and Thornmail right now, so it would be very unlikely with this single damage composition from Anarchy to actually pick up a win in this situation with a large gold lead that has been collected, and the fact that IM can pretty much just bait this Baron endlessly at this point. They have a couple of upgraded lenses, of course, this late into the game, so any ward clearing will come quite easily, and they can just do this Baron in a heartbeat.
Yep. That's right. Oh, Anarchy getting a little bit close here. Maybe wanting to fight this one.
I don't think they want to fight this.
Oh, I think they want to fight it.
I think they want to prevent this Baron from going down.
I think they want to fight this. Pretty sure.
IM can just start the Baron and force a fight out of this situation while they have all the edges.
Instead, they may just let this pink ward be taken by Vicky.
And let Anarchy push up the mid lane.
Yeah. Now, what is IM afraid of?
I don't know.
Really curious. Oh, here we go. Oh, no, Ignar. Not quite able to make a play out of that.
Didn't land the headbutt pulverize combo, so now they'll have to wait for those cooldowns to be up again. They absolutely can go for this Baron right now and just force an engagement.
Yeah.
There's not even a lot of magic damage there to take advantage of the fact that the Baron Shred exists.
Well, yeah, I mean, just Morgana and Lulu, basically.
Instead, they want to push down.
Well, they get a top turret, so that is something. Now pinging back towards Baron. Do they finally have the pressure?
They can do Baron so quickly, yeah, and they have a lot of tankiness right now.
No, hide and brush. There we go. Okay, now going after Baron, it will go down very quickly, and look at Anarchy. They're spread out all over the place right now, finally grouping up near Baron. We'll see if the teleport comes in from CV Max. Lyra gets pushed away here a little bit. Yep, Baron taken very easily by IM. Oh, and we're not done yet. Songyun getting ulted with that wild growth. Meanwhile, CV Max inexplicably in the Baron pit for some reason. And IM pushing ahead. Ignar out of the fight for the moment. Songyun still untouched, so IM still needing to take Anarchy seriously.
Well, you just back off right now, defend their tier 2. Push up that mid wave again and start to take out the last tier 2 and close this game.
Yeah.
I am so afraid to make plays. It was so easy to do the Baron when they just started it. They could turn instantly, and any big commitment right there from Anarchy would more than likely not have succeeded.
This game.
This game indeed. So here we go, starting to move towards the bottom side right now while Cassiopeia pushes forward with those Baron-empowered minions.
Inhibitor's back for Anarchy now. And a recall from Mickey down in bot lane will get him something. Void Staff, okay, nice pickup for Mickey.
Well, with Frozen already having his Void Staff and another needlessly large rod, he's in much better shape.
Yeah. But it's still a nice pickup from Mickey.
It is.
You can't deny that.
I can't. I would never deny that from Mickey.
You can't take that away from Mickey. Well, meanwhile, Apple pushing this bot lane. We'll see if he is man enough to fight CV Max. Who knows? Roar having to be pushed back by Anarchy a little bit. And it is kind of tough to close. I suppose with the poke coming out of Mickey and Songyun.
Well, as long as this Hecarim can just push this minion wave into the tower, he should be able to clear the turret pretty easily with Sheen, especially since the rest of Anarchy is actually just getting zoned off, and there it goes down.
Yep, turret taken pretty easily by Apple.
It's like Ekrem just going to be joining the rest of his team right now as they want to destroy the mid lane inhibitor.
Yeah, I'm sure they're just going to walk in.
Songyun doing a good job of poking with those rockets, though. He's getting a lot of crits. Oh, that's scary, actually.
Yeah.
Just so many shields on him right there. You look at his shield, his health bar is just massive.
Jugger Jinx.
The Jugger Jinx, indeed.
Well, here we go. Apple coming in from behind onto Songyun, and Songyun immediately just blown up by Frozen and Apple. Now Snowflower in a lot of trouble. That's what Iam was looking for. Goodbye. Double kill now for Frozen.
I like that Iam made Anarchy feel safe by recalling after getting chunked and then just immediately teleporting back in with the home guards to catch him when he didn't have those shields up anymore. And at this stage, this should be a win right here as the Void Rush comes in.
Yeah, Baron buff gone, but they've got enough power that they should be able to just power through this with the AD carry out of the way. Yeah, the knockup's not a big deal as CV Max gets nearly taken out. Songyun ulting for that one, but Roar picks up the kill. Oh, Mickey getting very low. Oh, no! Oh, that was a good explosive cast from Lyra. Got them the kill onto Ignar, but it's not going to save their base as both Nexus turrets go down, and Iam, 42 minutes, finally taking down Anarchy in game number one.
And Iam showing that they have some decent teamfighting prowess and synergy right here. They just have to have more confidence in themselves to go into these teamfights and be decisive about their objective control. It was a good comeback win from Iam after suffering that 5-kill Jinx early on, but they caught out the Jinx in the bottom side, and right when Jinx was about to push down a lot of their towers and attain a massive gold lead, Anarchy sort of strategically crumbled.
Yep. And that is how you take advantage of a rookie team.
Yeah. Still a